Hello, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are all welcome once again to our grammar lessons with our companion An-Nahw al-Wadih. Inshallah, today we are coming to a whole new topic, different topic, away from the Jawazim al-Mudara. We've been talking extensively about Al-Adawat al-Lati تجزم فعلا واحدا. We've talked about الأدوات التي تجزم فعلين مضارعين. Okay, so today we are coming to look at الأفعال الخمسة وإعرابها. الأفعال الخمسة literally the five verbs وإعرابها and their grammatical analysis. How do they appear in a sentence when they are used to form a sentence? Now, when we say, though the book will explain to us what the al-af'al al-khamsa are, but then basically, when we say af'al al-khamsa, we are not talking about any specific five verbs. Like somebody might think, are they talking about zahaba, qala, jalasa, nama, shariba? Are they talking about some specific five verbs? No, we are not talking about any specific five verbs. When we say al-af'al al-khamsa, what we are referring to is that, you see, when you conjugate verbs, either on the 14 pronouns or on the 12 pronouns, when you finish your conjugation, look at the verbs that fall on the pronouns antuma. The pronouns antuma and then huma. And you look at antum and you look at whom and then anti. Again, when you conjugate or you see any conjugation of verbs, I want it to be as clear as possible. When you see any conjugation of verbs, the five verbs we are talking about here are the verbs, the conjugation, that fall on antuma and whom. Huma. Antum and whom and anti. So the five verbs are the verbs that match antuma, huma, antum, whom, and anti. What do we mean? We are talking about verbs that talk about you two, dual, you two. They, two, they, dual, two of them. You, plural. They, plural. And then you, feminine, singular. Since it's a video, I think you can repeat it. There wouldn't be any need for me to go back and forth. So let's say I pick a verb like zahaba. When I'm done with the conjugation, I'll realize that the one that falls on antuma will be zahabtuma. So when I'm done with the conjugation, I'll see zahabtuma. And then huma will be what? You have, we're talking about the present tense here. You are talking about the present tense because the past tense is already Mabni, is already construct, indeclinable. So we are talking about the past, present tense conjugation. Take note of that. So when you do the conjugation, realize that on the antuma, the verb that falls there, we are using zahaba in this case, you find antuma tazhabani. Antuma tazhabani. And then you come to huma, you see huma yazhabani. Habani. Antum tazhabuna. Antum tazhabuna. Hum yazhabuna. Hum yazhabuna. Anti tazhabina. Anti tazhabina. Take note of that. So I think you can right now pick any conjugation, or if you can do conjugation on your own, try doing a conjugation and look at the verbs with any verb at all that falls on antuma, huma, antum, hum, anti. Now the verbs that fall on these five pronouns are what we call al-af'al al-khamsa. When we say al-af'al al-khamsa, we don't mean any specific verb or any five specific verbs. We are just talking about verbs that fall on the conjugation of antuma, huma, antum, hum, and anti. So you see it clearly here, inshallah, as we go through it. And that is the present tense verb. Already, we've already learned that al-af'al al-madiyah, al-af'al al-madiyah, kulluha mabniyah. They are all indeclinable. So when we talk about i'rab, we are talking about what? The present tense verb. So you bring attention to that angle. Okay. Al-amthila, our examples. We have al-amilani, yashtagilani. Yashtagilani bimana ya'malani. They are working. Ishtagala bimana ya'mal. Al-amilani, the two workers, yashtagilani. They are working. Now, when you want to represent al-amilani with a pronoun, what pronoun will you give it? Of course, huma. Al-amilani, the two workers are working. So what do you say? Huma ya'malani. The two of them are working. So if you want to give it, replace it with a pronoun, you have here huma. Okay. And then here he says, antuma tashtagilani. The two of you are working. So you look at what I said. Here will be huma yashtagilani, antuma tashtagilani. So we have the huma, we have antuma. It says, al-ummalu yashtagiluna. The workers, plural, of amil. This is the dual of amil, a worker. And then we have here al-ummal, plural. The workers are working. So here we have what? If you replace this with a pronoun, what do you get? Whom? They are working. The workers are working. So if you want to give it a pronoun, you say whom yashtagiluna. Okay. Then we have here antum tashtagiluna. Antum tashtagiluna. You are working, plural. Anti tashtagilina. You, singular feminine, are working. Now, the af'al al-khamsa are these five. He used one verb here. So if we talk about af'al al-khamsa, we mean those verbs that fall on the meter. Yaf'alani. Take notes. Yaf'alani. Taf'alani. Yaf'aluna. Taf'aluna. And then what? Taf'alina. So you look here, you see the pronouns whom, well, huma, antuma, whom, antum, anti, as I've already indicated. Okay. Now we come to the next batch. It says al-amilani lan yashtagila. So here he just negated all of them with lan. They won't work. The two of them won't work. Antuma lan tashtagila, you two won't work. They al-ummal lan yashtagila, lan yashtagilu, they won't. So what you note here is that when the lan came, we have lan being introduced here. What happened to the verb? You see that the noon at the end is vanished. The noon at the end is vanished. And what happened? They just introduced one of the tools of nasb. Adatun min adawatin nasb. That's what basically they did. So the sentence is here like this. They just negated with it with lan. So they just fixed in there adawatin nasb to make the present tense verb we have here mansub. So from here your mind can tell you that when any of the af'al al-khamsa is mansub, its noon vanishes. You can see that we have a particular noon reoccurring here. That's why we call them what? Af'al al-khamsa. You realize that when you come here, all the noon are gone when they became mansub. When a fail that is of the af'al al-khamsa becomes mansub, the noon vanishes. Okay, let's proceed and see what we have next. So basically, we have أفعال الخمسة as مرفوع and all of them have نون 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 they are مرفوع because there is nothing affecting them here. When they became منصوب the نون vanished. Okay. Now let's see our third case which is the مجزوم. العاملان لم يشتغلا. The workers did not. لم, as I'm sure you've already learned its meaning several times, did not. The al-amilani lam yashtagila, the two workers did not work. Antuma, you two, lam tashtagila, you did not work. Al-ummalu lam yashtagilu, the workers did not work. Antum lam tashtagilu, two of you did not work. Antum, a lot of you, you plural, did not work. Anti, you singular feminine, did not work. You are speaking with a lady. Anti tazhabina. Anti lan tazhabi. Anti lam tazhabi. That is what Nahu is teaching us. It's teaching us how to vowelize accurately the endings of our words. How to put our words right grammatically. The, what's it called? There needs to be this... the words, there need to be this cohesion between the words. The words should just connect. See, this shouldn't pass. You shouldn't say, anti lam tazhabina. The moment somebody who knows Arabic hears this, they feel very bad, like a kind of headache. You give them migraine. So this is to directing us. That is not to say that when you're a beginner, you shouldn't speak. No. Of course, practice makes man perfect. You need to keep practice until you get it accurately. Okay, but we need to, nahu is what is guiding us towards أي نحو النطق كالعربي كالعرب عربي العصيل يعني. Okay. So when it became مجزوم also the noon can't be found. So basically even if before this نحو الواضي comes to teach us that when الأفعال الخمسة are مرفوع they come with the noon. When they are mansub, the noon goes. When they are majzum, the noon goes. He needs not to even teach us this now. From here, from our own eyes, we can see what's happening to the al-af'al al-khamsa. And af'al al-khamsa, I've told you that are these five that you are seeing here, the verbs that come after the verbs you are having here. Those are the af'al al-khamsa. Not this verb alone, any other verb that falls on this conjugation. So you realize that they are the conjugation that end with noon, 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 noon. Pick any conjugation at all and put this to test. Okay, let's come to the explanation. It says, انظر إلى الأمثلة في القسم الثالث في القسم في الأقسام الثلاثة المتقدمة. It says, look at the examples in the three parts, previous three parts. المتقدمة that we've just seen. It says, تجد الفعل المضارع يقع في كل قسم منها على خمس حالات. Says you realize that in each part, in each partition, let's just check the last one we just had here. It says تجد الفعل المضارع, you find the present tense verb in يقع appears في كل قسم in each part minha among it ala khamsi halat in five cases. It appears in five conditions. Okay, the five conditions are what we call the af'al al-khamsa. Conditions are that you hear this one being yashtagilani, tashtagilani, yashtagiluna, tashtagiluna, tashtagilina. Different five. Okay. So it's for huwa fil halati al-ula, it in the first case متصل بألف تدل على اثنين غائبين. He says in the first part of all of them, you find the first one متصل connected with, it is attached to ألف, a particular ألف. This ألف تدل على اثنين غائبين. It points to, when we say غائب in grammar, when we say ga'ib in grammar, we mean third person. We have mutakallim, first person, mukhatab, second person, غائب, third person. So he says, the alif you find coming with the verb, this particular alif, I'm sure you have the book, but I need to be scrolling back and show you something. Yashtagil, the verb is yashtagil for the singular. Now what happened? We said al-amilani, the two workers. So we needed to do something to the verb to match the dualness of the subject. So we added alif here. This alif you are seeing after the lam is what we called alif al-ithnain. Alif al-ithnain. Alif al-ithnain. Alif of dualness. It is the alif that shows us that this verb is talking about dual. You come to see waw, and the waw is what we call waw al-jama'ah. You come to see the yai, and the yai maybe yai in... I think the yai here in this case will represent something else. So let's just... So the alif you have here is the dual, and then we have the waw al-jama'ah. Okay. So what is he trying to tell us? Trying to tell us in the first case, you find this alif, and this alif tadullu ala ithnain ga'ibain. It refers to two third persons. Any third person dual. Wafi athaniya. In the second one, you find, he says, wafi halati athaniya. متصل بألف تدل على اثنين مخاطبين. And in the second, you find it referring to two people. That is what مخاطبين, second person dual. Second person dual. I اثنين مخاطبين. Second person dual, which is the أنتما. The first one was what? هما. They, two. Two. The second one, if you read, I'm sure you have the book now, you see antuma, you two. So second person, dual. وفي الحالة الثالثة, and in the third case, متصل بواو. In the third case, you find it attached to a particular waw, and this waw تدل على جماعة الغائبين. It points to جماعة الغائبين is what? Third person plural. Jama'at al-ga'ibin, third person plural. Which is what? Whom. Whom. وَفِي الْحَالَةِ الرَّابِعَةِ. And in the fourth example among all of them, fourth one, مُتَّصِلٌ بِوَاوٍ تَدُلُّ عَلَى جَمَاعَةِ الْمُخَاطَبِينَ. You find it referring to جَمَاعَةِ الْمُخَاطَبِينَ. Jama'at al-mukhatabin is what? Second person plural. Second person plural. وَفِي الْحَالَةِ الْخَامِسَةِ مُتَّصِلٌ بِوَاوٍ تَدُلُّ عَلَى الْمُخَاطَبَةِ. Al-mukhatabah is what? Second person feminine. Look at the ta marbut there. مُخَاطَبَةِ, second person feminine. So when you come here, just right above here, you see, this alif you have here is pointing to third person dual. Here in this case, the alif we have is pointing to second person dual. Here we have a particular waw here, and the waw is pointing to what? Third person plural. And then the waw we have here is pointing to second person plural because of the antum. And then we have anti, tashtagili, tashtagili. The yai here is pointing to mukhataba, second person feminine, singular actually. Okay, let's go again. وَمِنْ أَدْلِ ذَلِكَ. As we go on, it keeps getting tougher. It will even get much, much tougher. But because you've already built yourself coming, and I'm sure you've revised very well, the lesson wouldn't seem confusing to you. And if it does, any juz'iyah, any part that tries to confuse you, then you ask and clarify. Don't allow it. Okay. وَمِنْ أَجْلِ ذَلِكَ تُسَمَّ الْأَفْعَالُ الْمُضَارِعَةُ. وَمِنْ أَجْلِ ذَلِكَ تُسَمَّ الْأَفْعَالُ الْمُضَارِعَةَ فِي الْحَالَاتِ السَّابِقَةِ بِالْأَفْعَالِ الْخَمْسَةِ. And so, the previous five cases, the present tense verb in the previous five cases, are called al-af'al al-khamsa, as I've already explained to you, because they fall on these five conjugation styles. So they are the what we call al-af'al al-khamsa. تأمل هذه الأفعال الخمسة في الأقسام الثلاثة. Says, look at these five verbs in the three parts. تجدها في القسم الأول مرفوعة. You find it in the first part as مرفوع, as I have already indicated. لأنها لم تسبق بناصب أو جازم, because it hasn't been preceded with any ناصب or a جازم to make it منصوب or to make it مجزوم. We've all seen that. وفي القسم الثاني منصوبة. And when you come to the second part where لن was introduced, it is now منصوب. لأنها مسبوقة بأداة نصب, because in the second case it has been preceded by أداة نصب, and the أداة نصب is what لن in this case. لن, if it was preceded by أن, the same thing will happen. إذن, the same thing will happen. All these adawat nazb, kay, lam ta'alil, and all those stuff, the same thing will happen. The same effect of the noon going off will happen. It says, وَفِي الْكِثْمِ الثَّالِثِ مَجْزُومَ. The last part we had, where lam was introduced, it became majzoom. لِأَنَّهَا مَزْبُوقَةٌ بِأَدَاتِ جَزْمٍ, because it has now been preceded by adat jazm, which is lam in this case. If la and nahiya came there, I say la tadhhabi, la tadhhabi. I won't say la tadhhabina. If I say la tadhhabina, it is not la and nahiya. I'm not commanding, I'm not prohibiting her. If I'm going to tell a girl do not go, I have to say la tadhhabi, la ta'kuli, la tashrabi. I hope it's understood, because when I say la, I'm using a la and nahiya, and la and nahiya, as we've learned, is jazima. So if jazima comes and I bring the af'al al-khamsa, I know that the noon at the end should go. I'll say la tadhhabu, la taqrabu, la taqrabu az-zina, la taqrabu, la tashrabu, la tanamu. Say lam taqrabu. Okay, lamma taqrabu. All the adat jazm have the same effect as that. All the adat nazb, they also take away the noon. They all take away the noon. He says, walakin ma alamat al-raf'i wal-nazbi wal-jazmi huna. What are the signs of raf'u, nazb, and jazm in this case? He says, innana idha ta'ammalna al-af'ala allati ma'ana. He said, if we should look critically at the verbs that we have here, says لم نجد أثرًا, we won't find any sign للضمة, of ضمة. There is no sign of ضمة, so that we say مرفوع ولم ترفعه الضمة. We won't find anything like that. أو الفتحة, أو الفتحة or فتحة. There's no فتحة. أو السكون, there's no سكون, so that we say مجزوم ولم تجزميه السكون. The سكون is not there. So the basic signs of إعراب do not come in here. I've told you that we have al-alamat al-i'rab al-asliya. Alamat al-i'rab al-asliya. The basic signs of i'rab. Those are fatha, dhamma, kasra, sukun. And then we have alamat al-i'rab al-far'iyya. Secondary signs of i'rab. It's not always that you see fatha, kasra, dhamma, sukun. At times the i'rab is done by waw, by alif, is done by hazf al-noon, is done by noon, thubut al-noon. So we should take note. Okay, so it says, in this case, if we should look for the signs of raf'u, nazb, and jazm, we won't find any sign for dhamma, any fatha, or any sukun here. We won't find such. It says, walakinna fi halati raf'i, says, but in the case of raf'u, نجد في آخرها نونا ثابتة ثبوت النون. He says, but if you should look the first one, when the verbs were مرفوع, when all the verbs were مرفوعة, نجد في آخرها, we find at the ending of the verb نونا ثابتة, a firm noon, an existent noon, as I showed you above there. So you hear yadhhabuna, yaquluna, yashrabuna, yanamuna, yashtagiluna. You find it with the noon at the end. In that case, the verb or the fi'lun min af'al al-khamsa is marfu. When it comes with the noon, it's marfu. It says fi akhira noonan thabita da'iman kama fil amthilati al-qism al-awwal, as we have in the first part. Now let me run you there right away. The first part is talking about these first five. So you find all of them with the noon. In that case, the verb is marfu. Okay. And then what does he say? He says wanajid hazihi noon mahzufa. You find that this noon is mahzufa, is deleted. Fi halatin nasbi, is deleted when the verb is mansub. Fi halatin nasb, that is the case of accusative. Wal jazm, and when it is jusif or when it's mazum, the noon is deleted. Kama fil amthilati alqismayn alakhirayn, as it is in the last two parts where the lan was introduced and where the lam was introduced. Fala budda izan an yakuna thubuta noon, so definitely the thubuta noon, existence of the noon, should be na'iban, should be a replacement an dhammati for the dhamma. Because when it is marfu and noon is there, we know that the basic sign of raf is waw, is dhamma. So since dhamma is not there and it looks like the noon is the sign, then noon is niyabatan an dhamma, ay na'iba an dhamma, it is replacing the dhamma. Fi halat raf, in the case of raf. Wa hadfuha na, and is omission na'iban an al fathati was sukun, is omission, that omission of the noon replaces fatha and sukun. In the case of fi halat nasb, in the case of nasb wal jazm and jazm. So when you have al af'al al khamsa, basically when they are marfu'a, they come with their noon. All the af'al al khamsa, they end with noon. So you check the conjugation, the verbs that end with the noon, you see that they are the af'al al khamsa. Okay. Now when the noon is there, it means the verb is marfu'. And when the noon is taken off, it can be mansub or majzum, depending on the article that precedes it. If the article is of the nawasib, then it becomes mansub. If the article is of the jawazim, then the verb becomes majzum. Okay, let's take the qa'ida. Al-qawa'id. The laws here are al-af'al al-khamsatu. Here, kullu mudari'in ittasalat bihi. So he's defining al-af'al al-khamsa for us. He says it is every present tense verb ittasalat bihi that has been attached by alifu ithnaini, alif of dual, aw wawu jama'atin, or waw of plural, aw ya'u mukhatabatin, or ya'i that shows second person feminine singular, as we have in the ta'kulina, tashrabina, tanamina. The yai that comes before the noon at the end is what we call the yai mukhatama. So every verb that is attached with alif ithnain, waw jama'a, or yai ya'u mukhataba, is what part of the al-af'al al-khamsa. Okay. And then he says al-af'al al-khamsa too, the present tense verb, now they are i'rab. So here is ma hiya al-af'al al-khamsa, what are the af'al al-khamsa here. And then here he says, they are going to talk about kayfa tu'rab al-af'al al-khamsa. How do we do the i'rab of the af'al al-khamsa? Al-af'al al-khamsa to turfa'u bi thubut al-noon. Af'al al-khamsa, when they are marfu, their sign is what? Thubut al-noon. Wa tunsab, and when they are mansub, wa tujzam, and when they are majzum, their sign becomes hazf al-noon, omitting the noon or deleting the noon. Now let's get up a bit. Let me see for some i'rab here. So we have al-amilani yashtagilani. So yashtagilani, al-amilani of course is mubtada marfu, is mubtada marfu'un, wa alamatu raf'ihi al-alif, alamatu raf'ihi الألف لأنه مثنى. Okay, now that is for the مبتدا. Let's come to the خبر, which is the فعل المضارع that we have here, which is part of the أفعال الخمسة. Says يشتغلان, you say فعل مضارع, فعل مضارع مرفوع وعلامة رفعه ثبوت النون. فعل مضارع أو الفعل المضارع مرفوع وعلامة رفعه ثبوت النون لأنه من الأفعال الخمسة. I hope that is clear. You can add والألف, ألف اثنين. You can add that if you want. You come here, it says العمال يشتغلون. يشتغلون فعل مضارع مرفوع وعلامة رفعه ثبوت النون لأنه من الأفعال الخمسة. Now let's jump quickly to the منصوب. We have العاملان لن يشتغلا. يشتغلا, of course, لن is أداة نصب مبني على السكون. Think of يشتغلا. يشتغلا is فعل مضارع منصوب بلن, وعلامة نصبه is what? حذف النون. فعل مضارع, فعل مضارع مرفوع وعلامة رفعه حذف النون, deleting the noon. لأنه من الأفعال الخمسة, because it is part of the أفعال الخمسة. And the ألف, of course, ألف الاثنين. Okay, مجزوم the same إعراب. لم أداة جزم مبني على السكون لا محل له من الإعراب. يشتغل فعل مضارع مجزوم وعلامة جزمه حذف النون لأنه من الأفعال الخمسة. خلاص كده. The قواعد again. He says what? الأفعال الخمسة هي كل مضارع اتصلت به ألف اثنين أو واو جماعة أو ياء مخاطبة. الأفعال الخمسة ترفع بثبوت النون وتنصب وتجزم بحذفها. Please, the قواعد, if you can be memorizing them, it will be very good. After understanding them, you memorize them. Okay, inshallah, this brings us to the end of this lesson. I think it has been a lengthy one, but then worthy. Okay. May Allah grant us beneficial knowledge and make our knowledge beneficial to the Ummah. Till we meet again, have a very good time. Please do all to revise. Even when the lesson hasn't dropped yet and you think you are done with the current lesson, do all to revise previous lessons in your book. Try to revise and go through the assignment. Whatever is difficult thereof, you let us know to some extent. We don't solve the assignments here. They are basically assignments for some madaris and for yourselves. So you do yourself to go through them and try your hands on certain things. Practice. Most important of studies of language is practice. Okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.